There was very happy times, man, and it was like times that were just like, you know, we wanted to kill each other.
Harry drove a wedge between himself and the band.
The joke was, you know, Elvis has left the building. You know, we'd get off stage, he'd take off in his car and he'd be gone and we'd be sitting around and we'd meet the fans. There was no more Steve, you know.
It was awful. And we were, you know, flying around without him. It was weird.
But Steve Perry's distance wasn't the only thing gnawing at the fabric of the group. By early 84, Neil Schon had recorded two albums outside of Journey, including one with jazz impresario Jan Hammer.
Lies, no more lies.
One of Neil's solo songs, No More Lies, became a modest hit. Journey even featured Neil playing the tune during the Frontiers tour.
It was just something that I wanted to do artistically. Steve seemed more perturbed than anybody to me about it.
I had asked that he not do any solo albums because I was telling the manager that it would only entice me to want to do one.
Kirby says he understood Steve Perry's concerns. He too felt that Neil should never have pursued the solo work.
I said, when Steve Perry ever decides to do this, it's going to be mainstream and you will rue the day you ever satisfy these little desires. Well, it's like you're with the wife, but you're lusting after others. And, you know, and monogamy is not a hardwood in Brazil. You know, this is Journey. This is your wife. And you have to be loyal.
Now it was his turn to feel betrayed.
I was not making commercial records anyway. I was not making anything to even put next to Journey and say, well, he's trying to do the same thing over here, only with someone different. It was completely something other. It changed my outlook in life. It makes you realize that the things that you were making a big deal out of maybe were not so big.